Sometimes we gotta slow it down. sometimes, you guys have special needs, you're not allowed to say the R word, retarded, not supposed to say it anymore, which is so weird, you know, because I got in trouble a couple years ago because one of my comedy specials, I talked about my cousin Tina. I said, I got his cousin Tina, and I said, she's retarded, motherfuckers got mad. He said, you can't say that word. I was like, oh, I didn't get the email blast. It's weird, because people were like, they're all up in arms, you know, just getting messages, you know. You can't talk about retarded people. I go, I didn't. I talked about one, my cousin. I didn't talk about a whole group, you know. It didn't make sense to me, because I didn't use it maliciously. I just used it as a description. I got a cousin Joey, he's tall. I got a cousin Tina, she's retarded. And the one person that wasn't mad was Tina. I didn't understand why everybody else was mad. And she was happy. I talked about her special and her friend group. She felt like she was famous. You know? Because I remember that when I saw her at a family function, she was so happy when she saw me. You know? Because I saw her, my special aired. And she heard that I talked about her, she just came running up. She's like, Gary! Gary! You talk about me on TV, Gary. You talk about me on TV. I said, I know, and then she spun away. She's like, Gary, talk about me on TV. I said, I don't know why we're not. Special needs people, they're the happiest motherfuckers on the planet. I've never been unhappy that I just spun out of a conversation. I want that level of joy one time in my life. I just talked to my Gary, what's up? Nothing, nobody did. And then Tina got confused when she found out people was mad about that joke, you know? Because next time I saw her, she was all confused. She came running up again, you know? She was like, Gary, Gary. Yeah, we're mad at me. What are you mad at, you fool? Remember my special? I said you're retarded? Mm-hmm, I am. I know. But I can't call you that anymore. Now I gotta call you special needs. So I'm not retarded anymore? No, you still are. You definitely are. I just can't call you that. But that's retarded. I know, that's what I said. Appreciate you guys laughing at that. Bear kicked in. So listen, every time we do a show, I'm always, when I see like a diverse group like this tonight, I'm always asking myself, what do we have in common? Because every comic's job, whether we do it in an arena or a coffee shop, is to get a bunch of people together and tell some jokes that everyone can agree upon. Okay, that's funny. Okay, I've had that life experience. It's not the easy job in the world. Because even right now, I'm looking around this room, man, we got a lot of different age groups, nationalities, tax brackets, political beliefs, religious beliefs. And I was like, what have we all got in common? And I don't think I would have thought of this if I didn't take that gummy about 30 minutes ago. But it just hit me. The one thing we all have in common in this room tonight, and that is that all of our moms got hit wrong. And that's why we're here tonight laughing. Yeah, your mom, bro, wrong. Is that your mom? I'm sorry. This show just got awkward as fuck. Just look at her. Mom, I mean, he ain't lying, though. Your mom, bro, wrong. Security, your mom, wrong. Your mom, raw. Look at all the backs that was blown out in this room. Don't owe me, owe your daddy. That's a weird thought. It's weird to think. At one point, everybody in this room, we was all just living in our daddy. And a couple seconds later, out of nowhere, we were living in our mommy. was the first race. I don't know what you see. I see a bunch of loose end bolts in this motherfucker right now. I see a bunch of people that wanted to live. You try to remember that. Life ain't going your way, things are getting a little rough. Just remember, there's a bunch of motherfuckers left behind your daddy's nutsack. They wish they could be out here right now laughing, but they can't because they were slow. They were losers. Showing. You ready for your headliner? Come on, Kansas City, you ready for your headliner? Really no introduction needed, the one, the only, Cedric the Entertainer!
Who was on strike and shit you could do. And I knew this, you know, I knew this black lady, you know, black, everybody knows somebody from the hood that know where the hookup is. And I knew this sister, she was like saying, you know, you give a check if you come over here. Now, you ain't supposed to say nothing because y'all on strike, but you can do your little shows, right? And I was like, straight? And I was like, what I got to do? She said, first of all, you got to do is come around all day. Come around the back, come around the back, come around the corner. You know what I mean? Get a hole to the nine. Pum, pum. And you come out, boom, bam, boom. You ain't you out, you gone. All right, check. You know what I mean? Now, for the white people in here, that was a full conversation, I guess I had. With the black people, they literally understood everything I just said. Right there. This is how we talk about y'all at work in front of you. This is me, this is me, I want to work on that. Trip, man. I did that shit. What up, player? What's going on, man? They got a towel and a stick and all kinds of shit going on, man. Are you a capper? Come on, like, you about to hit me a bit. Hey, man, shit life is crazy, man. You know what I'm saying? Been, you know, getting ready for the goddamn holiday, Thanksgiving. Everybody threw with the leftovers, y'all did it? All right, make sure, because you're just it, man. You can't even make it on ham sandwiches from that shit last week. Think about it. Christmas, that's one of them ones, you know. Christmas, one of them holidays is coming up. Used to be fun when we was kids, but now as an adult, you know, that shit ain't fun at all. Plus, my wife, she really be into the holidays. You know, she one of them people that get very competitive. We live in one of the neighborhoods where everybody decorate and shit. You know, it's cute when you little, like, oh, you don't live there. You get in the car, you ride around with your kids, and you say, look at all these lights. Look how pretty that is, you know. But when you live in one of those houses, your goddamn light bill be high in the motherfucker. Yeah, my wife's super competitive and shit, because the lady down the street last year, she had a lot of lights on her house. And then my wife saw the lights she had on her house, and she went and put some more lights on our house. And then the lady saw the lights that we had, and she put some more lights on her house. So then my wife went back out and got some more goddamn lights. We had so many damn lights on our house, I had to give my house a jump one day. And my house hooked up to the truck. Woo, woo. Try it now. Try it now, see if the house will turn it back on. We had a real nativity scene. I'm talking about the three wise men, you know, manger, baby Jesus. Well, it was a little Mexican boy, so baby Jesus, but everybody got it. They knew what was going on. You know, I'm out trying to find myrrh and frankincense and shit. Can't find frankincense nowhere. I'm all in the weed man and shit. You got some frankincense? Like, I got that Frankenstein. Yeah. I'm like, let me get a little bit. You know, for the kids. This is a trip, man. You know, I've been feeling good, though. You know what I'm saying? Listen to all the shit that's going on in the world. So much ratchetness, man. There's so much little shit you got to deal with. I talk about Travis Kelce because this interesting thing just happened in my life. With my daughter, she's 20, she started dating a little white dude. Called me off guard. I was like, ooh, I'm gonna be doing better than I think. The thing is that she was dating a little black dude. This motherfucker was doing everything little black dude was doing. And then he got caught putting dick pics all on the internet and shit. And then the white boy, he loved her to death. He all kind of shit. But he really is a white boy. He ain't cool, but not that cool yet. Like, he don't even know, like, the handshakes, you know what I'm saying? Like, you try to do this motherfucker with the black handshake, and he all hand all firm and shit. I'm like, man, you got to get a little cooler than that, bro. Like, damn. You then the next time he saw me, he thought he had it. This motherfucker had the dab and shit in that motherfucker. This nigga shit, my hands start crumpling and shit. Nah, you doing too much. Trip, man. Then listen to this music, man. This music been a whole thing different. Kid, my son wanted to go see Rod Wave. I went up on game. So he robbed with Rod Wave, you know. Then their songs are sad than a motherfucker. God damn, they be so real, don't they? They be mad for my dog in the car and it overheated. My favorite auntie lost her foot because she got diabetes. They gave me no obituary, I couldn't see. I love him though, goddamn, that nigga sad than a motherfucker. That's the thing about it, man. All this rap, you got them girls, these girls harder than the dudes. And that's the thing about it, they be saying shit. Think about girl rapping, I call it ratchet thought empowerment songs, cause they are, they write empowerment songs because for the ratchet though, you know what I'm saying? And dudes, we get caught up because I started trying to work out, you know what I'm saying? So I'm in spin class, and that's where they play a lot of that shit. And you as a dude, you realize, like, God damn, I ain't even supposed to be liking this shit right now. I've been trying to work out, I'm a savage. Body, booty, bang, nasty, savage. Booty, body, nasty. This ain't gangsta at all. It's hard to be working out, dude. You got on your goddamn shorts, shirt out to my body, yada 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 yada. And sometimes they should catch you off guard because you like to be a real motherfucker, right? You in class listening to this shit, this empowerment ass songs. And they'll have you as a real dude all confused. Cause I'm in there working out one day, and chick in there, they play this motherfucker. I'm in there about to work out. This motherfucker all right here. And I'm like, shit, when I hear the song, I'm like, oh.
Say some shit to make a grown man blush. Them motherfuckers be saying some shit. mother come on the radio. I fuck your man and drive off in a ride, send your nigga home with his dick tied. You be like, whoa! Whoa, young lady. Don't send that man home with his dick tied. That is disrespectful. Not tired, okay, not the dick tied. What the fuck? These little dudes, they just as wild, everybody violent as fuck. I don't need no security, got my own fire in the club. That boy said he shot up everywhere there was. What? Everybody got drink on, got that drink on, got the rata. Crazy. You think about it sometimes, you know, we love rap. I grew up on rap. A lot of people be like, see, you old now. You just old. You don't know rap. I know rap. I know. We grew up on that shit too, nigga. I know everybody. I know all the Lil's, nigga. You know all the little Lil's, little Yachty, little Boots, little Wayne. All the, I know the young Dolph, young Jeezy, young Pro, nigga, all the youngs. The thing is that I admit though, shit, I like rap, but after 10 o'clock, you gotta turn that shit down. It's time for some CNN going around here. Find out what's going on with the world. I got my socks off and everything, but I tell you, you fuck around with you good niggas now, that's enough. Earlier in the day, sure, I got it. You think I saw that you realize it just gonna be your truth as an adult. They ain't saying they ain't got hot shit. I get it. But after a while, it just gonna be your truth and it get caught. Catch you out there as a grown person with shit to do tomorrow. 21 Savage had a song about last summer. That was my shit. I love this song. I'm gonna be on the first part of the song was my shit. It ain't how much money you got, a lot. How many partners you got, a lot. How many lawyers you got, a lot. How many niggas you shot, whoa. How many times you got shot? Wait a minute. I mean, I've been dealing with a little gal, nigga, but I ain't shot nobody. I'm nothing. 21, that ain't on God, nigga, that ain't me. They got language we don't quite understand. They got their ops. Nigga got my ops outside. Nigga the crazy crap. Fuck nigga, fuck boy, fuck pussy, bitch. They cuss their ass off. That's the thing about it. I really appreciate that. I love it. Cussing. And you don't like boy, these good kids, they cuss their ass off right now. Especially down south. And fuck boy, they won. If mother called you a fuck boy, you've literally been cussed out at the highest level of cussed outness. Just know that. Mother go fuck boy, old pussy ass, fuck ass. I'm sorry, what did I say to you then, man? I said, were you gonna give up that parking space? That's all I asked. Fuck ass, pussy ass, bitch ass. Fuck on. Lights. Extremely aggressive, young fella. Fuck boy. Fuck ass. They say this shit a lot. It would be y'all in the song too. Fuck boy, pussy bitch. Fuck nigga. We didn't grow up like that. That's all I'm saying. We didn't have that degree of cussing in our song. We had been one or two cuss words when we grew up. It was bad, bad Leroy Brown, you know, bad man in the hole. Damn, that was it. As hard as it got, we didn't fuck nobody over. I couldn't imagine our singers doing that shit. Ron Heisman, nigga on stage, you're a fuck boy.
I'm trying to imagine even some of them OGs like Frank Sinatra. Frank on stage saying that shit in the song. That shit would be different as fuck, boy. Frank be out on stage, OG and that shit, come on, nigga. You're a fuck boy. You know, I am officially up at this point. I just recognize you're up, man. I try to get rid of this gray hair. That motherfucker, gray hair boy, is a motherfucker, boy. I don't care what the hell you do, man. You can try to dye that motherfucker, cut it off. That shit show up like an old Jamaican the next day. Like, why are you talking about? Why you see it? Why are you coming back around soon? Boom, a clot. This shit come on back. That motherfucker gray hair is gangster as fuck. Thing is, you don't know you old, though. That's the thing about being old. You feel good. Old on, because it ain't the same 50 that we used to be. Then when we was young, and motherfucker was 50, you be like, God damn, that motherfucker old as fuck. Now, any of us in here 50, we like, fuck that shit, dude. I'm still outside. Walking pigeon toes now. This is fun, man. I think I give a fuck, man. It ain't the same thing. But age is age. That shit will let you know you old. It'll just pull up on you, uninvited. You'll be pouring cereal, nigga. Your meal go out, dude. He's an army movie, that's what I'm talking about. And then what lactose do make you leave? Lactose intolerant. We old, nigga. Dudes, we old, we got noises and shit, you don't even know we make it. Dude, we got noises sitting down and wanting to get up. Too many noises. See, the obvious to us, but we dudes, we love our cars and shit. Usually we really, when we young, we like, all right, partner, I'll let you, boy. We go, we step into the rack. And we go, scared, we out. And you get old, and you be like, all right, boy, I'll let you. But I'm like y'all, I'm like me, I feel like y'all, I'm young and old, I ain't old, old. I'm young and old. You know what I mean? I still pull up, goddamn, right back. Y'all tell me y'all going somewhere, nigga, I'm pulling up, I don't give a fuck. I'm young and old, I do young and old shit, you know? Because I'm young on one side, like, I got a couple sports cars and shit, you know? Then you pull up on me at a red light, looking over at me, getting a rev in your engine and shit, looking at me. Oh, I'm gonna race your ass. I don't give a fuck, man. I can pay for my ticket. Ooh, let's go. At the same time, I'm old. I recognize I'm old. Because even if it's 85 degrees all day, and it's 85 degrees, it's all day long, but I know that I'm going to be gone all day, don't you feel like sweat over me? I'm going to let you motherfucker judge me. It's going to be a breeze around 6:30, 7 o'clock. It was always cold in that goddamn movie theater. I didn't like to walk in there without my sweater, okay? Real sweater. Thank you. I'm young old, nigga. I'm young old in the sense that, like, if, you know, we just had Thanksgiving, you got barbecue, picnic, you know, something like that. I'm young old in the sense that, listen, if we gonna have a barbecue or picnic or something like that, you know, I know how to put my shit in the microwave and warm it up 2 minutes. I ain't old school like my grandmama the other bless. Gotta turn the oven back on. You know, it'd be a fucking hour and a half later, and you still ain't getting over there. I'm like, God damn, grandmama, I ain't leaving the cornbread, man. I just trying to give me a little quick little something. You know, thank you, sir. Then at the same time, I'm old school, because if I'm at a barbecue or a picnic or something like that, I expect my woman to make me a plate. You can see a couple of claps over here, a lot of people looking around, I'm sure if it was okay to clap on that one. A lot of people were very, see, like the OG, like young bro, like that. Some of the old ladies, they get it, they understand it. I see all the young girls in here like, make you a wig, nigga. Make you a wig. Make me a plate, motherfucker. That's what I said. Young ass girls, they don't even know what a plate is, dog. That's a real art form making a plate. That's four food groups and two things I didn't know they had on there. You didn't see the baked beans? You didn't see the baked beans. All I know is Emily put baked beans on Charles' plate. All right. Let's see what this is. There's so much shit going on in the world, all this goddamn. Boy, last Friday was a motherfucker. I call it Black Friday for real. But forget Thanksgiving, boy. They had Pete Diddy on the list. Motherfucker L.A. Reid on that motherfucker, Jimmy Ivey on that bitch. Nigga, I was holding my phone low than a motherfucker. Thing is, they getting people, they going back, they getting people on their proclivities, you know. They sexual proclivities, and we all have them, you know. A lot of y'all know what proclivity is. This is the shit that you enjoy that may work in one relationship that don't necessarily transfer over to the next relationship. Everybody don't like to get choked, dog. I mean, look at you, you're a choking motherfucker. Yeah, that motherfucker like choking people. I can look at it. Yeah, that innocent ass smile, I'm like, you like this shit. Ladies, everybody don't want to get scratched on the back, don't scratch me. I'm too mysterious. Okay? I don't like it, all right? Don't call me daddy. It's too much responsibility. You want to be free with me? Come up with a name. Darnell, Darius, anything like that. It's something different, you know what I'm saying? But don't call me daddy. I'm not gonna pay nothing else around it. Proclivities, you know what I'm saying? Your proclivities will get you caught out there, you know? And that's the thing about it. Sometimes you don't know where the line is. That's the problem. People don't know where the line is because you're trying shit and everybody kind of like it, you know? Like right now, if I was like, hey, girl, you know what? I'm gonna take this motherfucking honey, I'm gonna drizzle that shit all over your body, and I'm gonna take my time. I'm gonna lick that shit off. See, I had a laugh so it's less creepy, right? No, maybe the laugh make it more creepy. I didn't really. The laugh, I'm just gonna hurt the laugh this time. I might take the laugh out. I don't think I'm gonna take the laugh. She's like, yeah. I'm like, girl, I'm gonna take this pump of whipped cream, I'm gonna put it in your belly button, I'm gonna see there, I ain't get one. Ooh, that bad. You know why? Because those are normal sexual condiments. That's what's wrong with, that's why. Everybody know the regular sexual condiments we use. That's easy. Everybody kind of good with their whipped cream, you know, honey chocolate, you know, the strawberries, you know, movie butter, you know, all the regular shit. You know, I'm the kind of motherfucker that like one of, you know, put a little sriracha on your nipples. You know what I'm talking about? Spice it up at night. Go around and douse your ass in some low sodium soy sauce. You feel me? You gonna be another bowl of rice tonight, girl? Don't take my shit, dog. That's the young man. And then talk about low sodium. That's one of the green top. It's green top, right? That's good looks, man. I need to cut my sodium down. She's crazy. I've been having a good time in the world, man. I had a book out, man, tripping box cars. I gotta go grab that shit. Wrote a book about my grandpa. I got a song out. What my song? I put a little Stepper Joint out, man. Y'all gotta check a little song out, man. I put my little Stepper Joint out, man. I was just having a good time. Shit is smooth shit, step a song, say it every time at San Francisco. Thing is, I don't know how much I want to be a singer, you know, a lot of motherfuckers is getting in trouble, everybody, you know. Thing is, you know, you gotta be careful, you know, DDM, everybody was coming at me all the time, looking like, say, like you've been doing this shit a long time, nigga. It's hard to be around this long and not be in the Illuminati. I know you in the Illuminati. Like, nigga, I'm not in no goddamn Illuminati. I know I'm not. I never got an email or nothing. I don't know. I'm looking for the email. Like, nigga, what's up with the Illuminati shit? You know what I'm saying? So, thank God, I'm trying to see where the Illuminati motherfuckers going. I ain't in no secret society like that. Well, you know, not that kind. I'm going to admit to y'all tonight, I am a part of the secret society. But not that one. I am a part of a small secret society. A lot of y'all are members in here. I can look around and tell. And we are not Illuminati people. We are not Illuminatis. We are a lot of dollars, though. We are a lot of dollars. And I can look in the room and tell there's several lot of dollars in here. And people are like, nah, I ain't in that shit. Say, fuck that. I'm like, yo, there's a lot of dollars. I can look at you and tell you a lot of dollars. And it is, because there's a group of us still in Hollywood, every now and then. We get together, and it's people y'all know. I ain't gonna start naming names tonight, but it is people y'all know, and we do get together every night, and we don't do it all the time. But we still get together and listen to R. Kelly records, okay? So, we ain't supposed to do that shit, but we do it. And I know y'all do, I can tell, there's a lot of our names, because R. Kelly, he's just one of the people. Yeah, he fucked up, yeah, he a jerk. All right, he did a horrible thing the man did, okay? Horrible. Roberts is in jail. Roberts. What do the songs have to do with anybody? That's all I need to know. Because a lot of y'all right now, I went, my mind is telling me no, but not. Thing about it is that R. Kelly just one of those people, man. He wrote some of these songs that was just so essential to our culture, man. Step in the Name of Love, nigga, that was one of them. My grandma used to love that song. You couldn't make her happier than me. Now I know somebody's having a birthday tonight. Somebody, you like, just that happiness that she felt when she heard that song, man. Fucked up. thing is, and then he the only dude that ever wrote a song for men when we fuck up in a relationship. There's only very few songs that black dudes have when we emotionally tied in a relationship and it hurt, our heart hurts. And he wrote a song for that that really means something to us. Like, women, y'all got 100 songs. When a relationship go wrong, y'all ain't, how did you get there? Nobody's supposed to be here. I'm going down. I'm going down. No, 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 wait. I'm living without you. Y'all got y'all wine out, that's right, girl. Come home late, seeing you barely beat the sun. Tapping my shoulder, thinking you gon' get you some. Smelling like a fragrance I don't even wear. If you want some loving, I suggest you go back there. See, that part right there, that little extra. That's the part dudes hate, that little extra ass. Where you came from? Right now, Kim, you had to be a major point now. That we had shit. Thing is, R. Kelly, he wrote one for us as the dudes. Like, you know what I'm saying? We got two songs that dudes can let it all out. When we, with our heart hurt, and we cry, we got the OG. Oh, 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 do, 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 do. That's when we fucked up, and we cried, and we want our woman back. Then we got this motherfucker by R. Kelly, this motherfucker right here. Just have us, nigga, we be like. Nigga, we fucked up! And we want a woman back, nigga. Nigga, our heart be hurt. R. Kelly broke that shit down so quickly, and he just told us we're being fucked up. He just be like, nigga, look what you did. Look at you.
Standing here looking in the mirror. Shaming to myself. Should have known the day would come. She would hurt somebody else. And all the things I took her through. Shit, I should have lasted this long. Now I'm at this telephone.
Who we got? The little one is head up, baby. That shit real as fuck. Yeah, R. Kelly caught the home moment. The video that nigga is outside in the winter in a convertible with the top down. That's exactly how we feel. That nigga is stalking her ass, nose running, and it's freezing before he gets to his vehicle. So nigga, back goddamn outside, right? And I don't give a fuck how gangster your ass is. If you love your woman, you love her for real, and your ass hear this goddamn song, and you be trying to be hard and hold on, I don't give a fuck how gangster your ass is. When them goddamn